Welcome back to Binge Worthy Network. From losing $250,000 to having a life-changing event, this is the story of how Kim Kardashian's best friend, Jonathan Chabon, was reportedly robbed at gunpoint. But before we jump in, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button if you love to hear about all the new Kardashian-Jenner drama. It's no surprise that drama and controversy surround not only the Kardashian-Jenners, but their close friends as well. For those who have been keeping up with the reality TV sisters, we'll know who Kim Kardashian's best friend is. Jonathan Chabon has been by Kim's side for most of her adult life, and as the KUWTK seasons went on, fans of the Kardashians have gotten to meet the real Jonathan. Fans all over social media were shocked to hear that Jonathan shared a very similar experience to his best friend Kim. It's a strange coincidence that both Kim and Jonathan have been robbed at gunpoint. But when it comes to Jonathan's robbery, the story is a little different. Here's how the whole robbery went down. On August 4th of 2020, it was revealed to the public that Jonathan Chabon, known as Food God on Instagram, was robbed at gunpoint in Englewood Cliffs, New Jersey. The reality TV star was apparently walking with his mother and his friend when a stranger approached him from the side. The stranger simply asked for the time, and soon enough, he got out his silver semi-automatic handgun and started pointing it at Jonathan. The robber and criminal knew exactly who Jonathan was because he demanded the watch Chabon was wearing. But what was so special about Jonathan's watch? Well, according to Kim's best friend and reality TV star, Jonathan was wearing a very special Richard Mille watch, which retailed for around $250,000. No wonder why the gunman decided to rob Jonathan. Imagine getting $250,000 just by stealing a watch. When it came down to the actual crime scene, the gunman apparently had backup criminals who helped trap Jonathan, his mother, and his friend between two cars. And that's how the criminals got a hold of Food God. Thankfully, the neighbors heard some noise from the crime scene and immediately called for help. The mugger had a gun pointed at my mother's head. There were two gunmen. It was frightening. It happened at 8:30 p.m. last night, just as the sun was going down, Chabon told Daily Mail. Thankfully, the robber only hurt Jonathan when he forcefully removed the watch from his wrist. Neither his mother or his friend were hurt by the criminal. But as you can imagine, even though this event may not have been physically traumatic, it was definitely a life-changing moment in Jonathan's life. The reality TV star opened up and has said, "Thank you everyone for your overwhelming concern for myself and family over the life-changing incident on Sunday night. It was a horrific experience, but thankfully we are fine." The reality TV star and Kim K's friend continued to add to his statement by saying, "I left Manhattan for the suburbs and the crime is following. Lock your doors and watch your back. Keep your family safe." When it comes to the actual criminals and robbers, Jonathan and his friend say that they were young men aged somewhere between 20 and 30. The gunman who asked for the time was wearing a purple shirt, jeans, and white-gray sneakers. His backup and co-criminals were apparently in gray hoodies that helped cover up parts of their face. Jonathan thankfully got a good look at the gunman, which helped the police and law enforcement to draw up proper sketches of the perpetrator. As of August 24th, the criminals are yet to be caught or captured by the police. Keeping Up with the Kardashians fans seemed really concerned about Kim's close friend. Not only was Jonathan robbed at gunpoint, but the fact that Kim K had a very similar experience makes the situation even more intense and worse. The infamous 2016 Paris robbery made worldwide headlines when our favorite reality TV star Kim Kardashian was robbed at gunpoint. On October 3rd, 2016, Kim K's life was changed forever. The Kardashian sisters were in Paris for the fall fashion show. As the girls say on the reality TV show Keeping Up with the Kardashians, Kourtney and Kim's former assistant, Steph, decided to go out that night. The girls thought they would hit up the clubs in Paris and invited Kim along for a fun time. Mrs. Kardashian West was tired that night and decided to stay in their hotel room and relax. Kim showered, undressed, and was resting in her room as usual when she heard some rumble outside her hotel room. The next thing the reality TV star remembers is gunmen in masks rushing into her room and tying her up. The robbers were disguised as policemen and got the information about Kim's room from reception. The gunmen came in rushing into the room and quickly grabbed the reality TV star. They put duct tape across Kim's mouth and tied her legs and arms. The robbers then continued to yell at the reality TV star as they demanded she says where the jewelry was hidden. Only a few minutes after rushing in and taping Mrs. West, the robbers successfully robbed the world's most famous reality TV star. These robbers walked away with jewelry worth around $7 million. One piece of jewelry that was stolen that night was Kim K's second engagement ring, said to be priced around a whopping $4 million. Not only were there millions of dollars stolen in just a few minutes, but this one night ultimately changed Kim and Kanye's lives forever. This one event was the turning point in Kim and Kanye's life. As you can guess, Kim was never the same after the robbery. It took weeks for the mother to come back to her senses. She even started to suffer from anxiety, panic attacks, and major depression. In the KUWTK episode, Kim bravely explains to her sisters what happened that night, but her emotional storytelling gave us an insight into what the reality TV star was actually going through. But as Kim later said on Ellen, this Paris robbery was kind of a blessing in disguise because it led to Kim focusing on greater things in life. Thanks to the robbers, Kim decided to pursue her dream passions and her family. 3 years after the robbery occurred, Kim K decided to finally pursue her lifelong dream of becoming a lawyer. Kim is now preparing for the California bar exam and is being mentored by top lawyers across the nation. Mrs. West also came to the realization that material things can always be replaceable, and it's not supposed to be one's drive in life. Kim soon stopped posting explicit stories online. She stopped showing off her jewelry and diamonds and began focusing on her kids. Kardashian also decided to not post anything in real life. Now, anything fans saw was hours behind, when Kim could be in a totally different place, safe from anyone else. And while Kim has risen above her trauma, it looks like Kanye is having a little more trouble with dealing with history. Years have passed, and it seems like Kanye is still shaken by the 2016 Paris robbery. In 2016, following Kim's robbery, Kanye suffered a manic episode, which resulted in the rapper seeking help in a psychiatric hospital. Even though the rapper was released in just 9 days, the complications of his manic episode have lasted for years. As soon as he was let out, Kanye rented an apartment in LA as a way to deal with his episode on his own. From having public meltdowns during concerts to checking himself in rehabilitation centers, it is no secret that Kanye has been on the more chaotic side of his personality. It was also revealed that the international rapper suffers from a mental disorder called bipolar, which makes Kanye's outbursts even more memorable. Recently, the rapper and Kim K's husband revealed to the world that he was going to run for president in 2020. On July 20th of 2020, Kanye West held a public rally in South Carolina, which almost ended his entire reputation and career. During an emotional speech about abortion, the father of four confirmed that he and Kim were thinking about having an abortion on North, revealing the family's biggest secret up to date. Not only did the revelation of this secret take over every social media platform and news outlet, but Kanye's further Twitter rants added more weight to the scandal. The rapper soon fled the scene and relocated to his farm in Wyoming, where he started seeking help for his recent public meltdown and manic episode. From his Twitter rant exposing the Kardashian family to completely ignoring Kim's calls and text messages, we can clearly see that Kim's 2016 Paris robbery caused a huge butterfly effect on the family and the entertainment industry. Now fans are wondering if Jonathan Chabon's robbery will have such detrimental effects on his future life and mental status. What do you think? Do you think Jonathan's robbery was staged at all? Will the criminals ever be caught? Is Jonathan lucky that the robber only took his watch? Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe and give us a like. And don't forget to turn on your post notifications and share this video with your friends. Later, everyone.